Lefty Gomez is just showing you his style when he did pitch. I don't know what he's doing right now.
Billy Martin
made that sensational play. That's as fast as he has run or anything recently, except to argue an umpire. And now, ladies and gentlemen, seriously, here is one of the keys with the Cleveland Indians in the middle 50s, and they had such great teams under Al Lopez. Bobby Avila, second baseman. Dick Rashi, the Springfield Rifle on the mound. Charlie Silvera is doing the catching. Joe Collins, the first base. Gene Michaels is short. Billy Martin forces second. Bobby Mercer at third base. Just looking on and not doing anything. Nina Slaughter in left field. Both of them. Gene. Oh, come on, Bobby Mercer. Look at that great throw. So hard to first base. You made Collins blink. The official scores after lengthy discussion have decided that was an error. Eddie Lopez now on the mound for the Yankees and the batter. Historically great. As a performer, one of the most outstanding, starting with the Cleveland Indians, into the administrative level, managed a while. Let's have a great hand for New Jersey, Larry Doby. Willie, they're giving you a half a hit on that because you scared Joe. running so hard. Here is Kenny Keller. He's the man who made the two great backhanded stops that broke the Macho's 56-game hitting streak. It was in Cleveland. Two wicked shots over the bag at third. But he was a great ball player. You expected him to do those things.
Talking about the Naugatuck Nugget, Specs Shea. And
And from the best part of an opera, I don't know what we want to do with that. All that music coaching at third is Robert Merrill. 3-2 the count. Three and two still the count. Kenny Kelton wasn't ready. He's playing third base. Mickey Berner. Michael around second, heads to third. John Credo throws back in. Mickey Berner, main charger throwing error. And he always was a great hitter. He won two American League batting titles. Coming up now, one of the newest entrants into the Hall of Fame, at long last, Enos Country Slaughter. And on the mound now, former Giant pitcher, Kim Hearn. Great staff the Giants had in the middle 50s. During the catching, Jackie Cope, Jeff Torborg. Bobby Inglis at second. Wayne Dwellinger at short. Kenny Kelton at third. Ain't nobody going. They held on to one ball, got one out of second. Dick Michael scores. Ball game's all tied up. Meanwhile, he had learned how to pitch. one-time mayor in North Carolina, of Wake Forest. One won the score. Ground ball second. And they get a double play. And the score at the end of one inning. Yankee opponents won, the Yankees won. And we skip rather rapidly from the first inning to the ninth inning. New rules. The sun is out too brightly for these veterans. But isn't it wonderful to see them out here and to think back to the times they gave you so many exciting times. Leading off in the first half of the second is the man we were kidding about a while ago. First base. He played with Washington and Cleveland. But he was a great hitter, having won two American League batting championships, hitting 337 on one occasion, 353 another, back in around 1946. There is our former Yankee first baseman who, in racing to his position to coach at first base, gives you the answer to any question you might have had as to why they did trade him away almost at once. Of course, there was a guy named Garrett on the first base. But it happened. Great singer. Love those Irish ballads. Buddy Hatch is outstanding. And down to third base, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting a look at the brother of today's guest of honor. Played for the Red Sox. And truly one of the all-time great players, the little professor, Don DiMaggio. Let's get a finger. 315 tight hitter, and he can go get in with the best of them when he was on defense. Vic Rashi, the Springfield rifle on the mound. Bobby Mercer. Now they're getting the hang of this game. Score tie, 1-1. Where do they get a uniform to fit you, Patrick? Can you imagine he used to be able to run? Here's Al Gianfrido. Will to stop the game. Joe DiMaggio go out and shake his hand and thank him for rocking at the tying home run in that 47. She gets two bases. You must understand that we have a pitcher playing right here, Tommy Byrne. And now on the mound, Whitey Ford. Bobby Thompson, the batter. Mercer to Collins. Al Confrito is around third. Bill Rizzuto's friend, our friend, everybody's friend, except when he was playing outfield for the Dodgers, Gene Hermansky. Wet it up, Whitey. Scratch it up. things are managing. Pull the muscle. Sorry about that. Work it out. That is the inning. At the end of an inning and a half, the score remains. Yankee opponents won. The Yankees won. I think this is the first year we've never had a manager for either team. Bobby Thompson is going in to play third base. Wayne Twilliger short. First. Outfield, I believe, remains the same. John Frito, Mays, and Larry Doby in right field. And on the mound, a little guy named Bobby Shank. He was a brilliant little pitcher with the Athletics. Finally came over to the Yankees. And in the 1952 All-Star game, some of you may remember, it was a curtail game, rain, at the end of 5 innings. And Bobby had just struck out 3 batters in a row. Billy Martin is up there batting right now. I mentioned it about chance because the 3 men he struck out. Al Gianfrido after it. Outstanding hitter, tough to get out, especially in World Series play. Bobby Almeida feeling. Over to Burner. Bobby Chance in the fifth inning to finish that strikeout in a row. Jackie Robinson, Stan Musial, and Whitey Loughlin. Then it rained. He had no chance go after Carl Hubbell's record that struck out in the first All-Star game. Ruth, Gary, Simmons, Cronin. Struck out 5 men in a row altogether. Dickie got it in. And opened it. Virgil Crutch on the mound. And Joe Collins the batter. Virgil Crutch. He wore games on the mound. Great starter with the Detroit Tigers. The umpire is the second base runner. Caught it. Fair ball. 2 bases. Ground rule level. Billy Martin scoring on the play, and the Yankees lead 2-1. Virgil Trucks in 1952, as he leads the game, I'd like to remind you that he pitched 2 no-hitters. And one of them was here, that was the second one, against the Yankees. Let's give Virgil Trucks a nice inning. It's always a tremendous achievement. That was 1952, the year after the runner for pitches. And on the mound, one of the truly great baseball performers, going into the Hall of Fame. He was in over 1,000 games. One of the greatest relief pitchers of all time. Hoyt Wilhelm. Played by Ryan Clark because of the fact that they had to trade him when they didn't have a catcher who could handle the knuckleball. Charlie Silver just popped up. As a matter of fact, in 1 September, Paul Richards, managing the Orioles, said to Hoyt, "Why don't you go ahead and start again? Pennant race is over." And so he did. And he wound up pitching a no-hitter against the Yankees. The Yankees leading 2-1, and this is the, we indicated earlier, similar to the last of the ninth inning, in that it's the last inning. Joe DiMaggio. Thanks for coming, everybody.